Take this. I will love you always, Waltz. In Vienna, I will dance with you in a costume with a river's head. See how the hyacinths line my banks. I will leave my mouth between your legs, my soul in photographs and lilies, and in the dark wake of my footsteps, my love, my love. I want to leave violin and grave, the ribbons of the waltz. In Vienna, ay, dias muchachas, un onde donde siosa la muerte, y un bosque de le palomas de cicadas, hay un fragmento de la mañana, en el zeo del escarcha, hay un salón con mil ventanas. Porque te quiero, amor mío. En el desván donde juegan los niños, soñar vías lucas de Hungría, por los murmores de la tarde tibia, viendo ovejas de lirios de nueve, por el silencio escuro de tu puente.
One of the things I learned about music modalities is that the consciousness of a time, of an emotional, you know, whether in the 20s, the 30s, the 1900s, the 1800s, the 1850s, is embedded inside of the music that was available to that consciousness. And it plays out the emotional capabilities of that consciousness of that time and place.
So is that why some people hate the music?
Yes. Because it cuts across what their belief system is. It cuts across what they're comfortable in releasing to. It cuts across some other aspect of their experience mm-hmm. that they're not willing to open to. So they'll hate it. They actually have an emotional, experiential quality to the music. Because the music all of that experience is embedded in the music. It's embedded in the tone on tone. It's embedded on the octave that's being played.
Holding hands at midnight, beneath the starry sky. Nice work if you can get it, and you can get it if you try. Two hearts become one.